Hey everyone, so today we are going to talk about basics of electric circuits. So we will see what is an electric circuit and the components involved in that. So I will briefly just touch upon those components in a very simple basic way. Okay, so I am not an electrical engineer, but yeah, the main aim is when people study differential equations, they come across the problems involving electrical circuits. So one should have this basic knowledge of electric circuits and how to solve differential equations involving this electrical concepts. Okay, so first let us understand the concepts and then we will jump to examples. Okay, so this is, I've just drawn one simple electrical circuit. Okay, so like here is you have the switch, here is you can say the battery plus minus, here is the resistor, here is the inductor, capacitor, again the resistor, and the current is flowing through this circuit. Okay, so this is an how in general a typical electric circuit looks like. Okay, so one can, if someone asks what is an electric circuit, you can say it's a circuit that consists of electric components like resistors, inductors, capacitors, which are connected through these inductive wires through which the electric current flows. So that's what you mean by an electric circuit. Okay, and resistors, they are usually denoted by this symbol. Inductor is usually a coil shape, that's why the coil over here. Capacitor, two lines, okay, and two terminals, I would say. And here is a battery and here is a switch. If the switch is closed, that means the current is flowing. If the switch is open, that means the current is not flowing. So these are the things. Okay, now let's go for the first point, resistors. Okay, so now when you have an electrical circuit, the current is flowing through the circuit. The basic job of a resistor is to reduce the current flow. So every circuit has some resistance to the flow of electrons. So thus we can say that resistance is a measure of the opposition of current flow in the electric circuit. So you have an electric circuit, it just measures the opposition of current flow. So in a circuit, usually when you see R, that means it's a resistor. This is the unit, which is omega, and we call it as ohm. And symbolically, this is how it represented in a circuit. Now all materials resist current flow. Okay, so like there are some materials like gold, say aluminium, silver. They have very little resistance. That means electric current flows smoothly, no problem. Okay, they offer very little resistance. So therefore, they fall into the category of conductors. Whereas there are materials that have high resistance, that means there the flow of currents or the electrons is very less. Like I would say examples like rubber, wood, plastic, okay, and they falls into the category of insulators. Okay, so higher the resistance, lower is the flow of electric flow, or the lower is the flow of electrons, and lower the resistance, higher is the flow of electrons. So that's the basic about resistors. So what is a charge or electric charge? Okay, so charge, it's a basic property of matter carried by some elementary particles that governs how the particles in that matter will be affected when you have electric or the magnetic field. Okay, so that's what you mean by charge or electric charge. And charge are usually of two types, positive charge and the negative charge. And charge is usually denoted by the letter Q, or some people also denote by small q. So that's the charge. And the rate of change of charge, that means dq by dt, is called as the current. Okay, so the rate at which the electrons flows through the circuit, or the rate of flow of charge, that we call as a current. Okay, so current we denote by I of t, or some people also by small I of t, and this is nothing but dq by dt. Okay, so that's about current, and the unit for current is ampere. The unit for current is ampere. And when we say that the rate of change of current is 1 ampere, that means what? In 1 second in a circuit, 1 coulomb of electrons are getting passed through that point. Okay, so per second in a circuit, through that point, 1 coulomb of charge is passed. And now you can ask me, what is 1 coulomb? So it is, I think actually I should have checked, I think it's 6.24. into 10 raised to 18 electrons. Okay, so in a circuit, in 1 second, this much amount of electrons is moving past a point, then we say it's 1 coulomb. Okay, so that's about the current. So like earlier we have seen tank problems, right? And there we have seen gallons per minute. That means through a point, how much water, amount of water is flowing per minute. And therefore we had that gallons per unit, if you see the earlier lectures. The same thing is here also. It is like through a point per second, say how much electrons or how much charge is flowing. And that's why the current. Okay, so you can just relate with that tank problem. Okay, now, so what is voltage? Like I have written, you can just think of it as a pressure. Okay, so you have a, it is a, the pressure by the electric circuit's power source. Like, so when you plug in, so you have a power source to the electric circuit. So it's a pressure from the electric circuit powerhouse that will push the electrons to perform a certain task like illuminating a bulb. Okay, so that's what you mean by the voltage. Or some people also define it as like, if you have 2 points, you just see the potential difference between the 2 points. That's why this voltage is many times also called as electric potential difference. So voltage is the difference between the electric potentials of 2 points, which is defined as the work needed per unit of charge to move a test charge between the 2 points. So that's what you mean by the voltage. And voltage is usually denoted by V, or earlier like they used to denote by E also, because electromotive force. So that was another name for this. So either you will see E as a notation or V as a notation. Okay, and this voltage, current and resistor, they have a very nice equation, Ohm's law. V is nothing but IR. So this is one thing you will be using to find the values of either one of this when two of them is given to you. Okay, so that's about voltage. Now let's go about for the inductor. So what is the inductor? It's a passive electronic component, okay, which stores the energy in the form of magnetic field when the electric current flows through it. What is capacitor? It is also the same thing. It also stores the energy, but it stores the electric energy in the electric field. So it stores an electric energy in an electric field. Okay, so both of them stores. Here you can think of magnetic field and here electric energy. And it has two terminals. So usually for capacitor, you will see a symbol like this. And this is always in coil. So therefore, it's a coil. Okay, so therefore, in the circuit, you will always see them by this representation as a coil. Okay, so that's about the inductor and the capacitor. So what is the job of an inductor? So in a circuit, when the current is flowing through it, the job of the inductor is to oppose the change in current flow. Okay, and how it does it? It does it by inducting a voltage across it. Okay, so by inducting a voltage across it, it opposes the change in current flow. And what is inductance? It is the property of an inductor that opposes the change in current flow. So just keep one thing in mind, larger the inductor, or I would say larger the inductance, the greater the capacity to store electrical energy in the form of magnetic field. Okay, so this is one simple phrase which you can keep in mind to understand the concept of inductance. Similarly, what is capacitance? It is the capability of the capacitor to store the electrical energy. Okay, so here magnetic and here electrical energy. And the last point is, the quantity of charge stored is directly proportional to the voltage applied and capacitance of the capacitor. So this is about the basics of electric circuits. Okay, now let's do some problems. So now in problems, I won't be solving all the problems. I will just give you good hints, and I will make sure that I will take you till that point from where you can solve on your own. Okay, so let's start with some examples. So before going towards example, these are the 3 equations that we'll be using while solving the problems on electric circuits. Okay, so when the resistor and the capacitor is given, we use this RC circuit equation. When resistor and inductance is given to us, resistance and inductance, that means we are going to use RL circuit equation. And when we have inductance, resistance and capacitance, when everything is given to us, then we are going to use this second order differential equation. So just pause the video, write down these 3 equations, and one more, like V is equal to IR, Ohm's law, that also you may need. Okay, so these are the things we are going to use to solve the problems. So now let's go for the first problem. So like the first example, capacitors is given to you, resistance is given to you, external voltage is given to you. You have to find the voltage across the electric circuit. So straight away you can see the resistance and capacitance is given to you. So you need to use RC circuit equation. So what is the equation? R dq by dt plus 1 by cq is equal to E. You simply put the value. So your dq by dt plus, this is 1 upon RC, so R into C. So this is nothing but 1 by 4, right? 1 by 4 Q is equal to 24 by 20, right? So this is what you get. And now I think it's easy to solve, right? There is nothing much in this. This is nothing but your first order linear differential equation. If you recall, dy by dx plus p of x into y is equal to R of x. This is a first order linear differential equation. And what here, instead of q, instead of y you have q, instead of x you have t. So what you do, you first find the integrating factor, e raised to integration of p of x dx, here e raised to integration of 1 by 4 dt, and then the solution is what, y into f. So here q into e raised to integration of 1 by 4 dt is equal to integration f into right hand side. In this case, this is the right hand side, dx plus c. So you solve this and you get your q equal to, right? And your job is to find voltage. Once you have q, you find dq by dt, you get your I. Once you have I, we know that v is equal to ir. R is given to you. From taking the derivative, you get I, and therefore you get the voltage. So that this is the hint for the first question. Let's go for the second question. Like if you're not comfortable with this, or if you're not sure whether you can solve it or not, you can simply pause the video and solve this. If you get stuck, you can ask me in the comment section. So here is another question. So a decaying electromotive force 200 e raised to minus 5 t is connected in series with 20 ohm resistor and 0.01 farad capacitor. You have to find the charge and the current, given that Q of 0 is 0. So this condition will help you to find the value of the constant. And you have to show that it reaches the maximum value. You have to find the time when it will reach the maximum value. And you have to find that maximum value. Okay, so these are the things one has to do. Okay, cool. So what we have E is given to us. Then capacitor and resistor. So RC circuit again. So one, so dq by dt plus 1 upon RC into Q is equal to E upon R. Now when you do this, you have dq by dt plus 1 upon RC. What is R? 20 into 0.01. So I think it is 1 upon 0.2. Right? So this is nothing but 2 by 10. So this is nothing but 5Q is equal to E upon R. So I have 10 E raised to minus 5T E upon R. Okay, so this is the differential equation we have, e raised to minus 5t. So let's try to solve this. So what you have, q into integrating factor e raised to 5t is equal to integration right hand side into integrating factor dt plus c. So your q e raised to 5t is 10, this is nothing but 1 only. So 10t plus c, so your q is 10 t e raised to minus 5t plus c e raised to minus 5t, right? This is the formula for first order linear differential equation. And when your q of 0 is equal to 0 implies 0 equal to, this becomes 0 plus c. So your c is 0. So c is 0, so this goes away. So this is my q. Fine. Now you simply take the derivative, you equate it to 0, you get the value of t, and I think it will come out to be 1 by 5. Once you have the t, you take dq by dt, double derivative of q, d2q by dt square. Okay, it will be negative, therefore the charge will be maximum. Okay, so there's the second thing. And then when your t is 1 by 5 or whatever the value you get after equating the derivative of this to 0, for that value of t you put over here, that is the maximum value of q. Okay, so take the derivative, equate it to 0, you get t. At that point, your double derivative will be negative, therefore you will have the maximum value, your basic calculus. Okay, and at that T, just put it over here, that is the maximum charge. So yeah, there's the hint for this question. Let's go for the next one. So here is another question. Inductance, resistance and force is given to you. I of 0 is 0. You have to find the time elapses before it reaches 90% of its maximum value. So because of these three things, I have to use RI circuit. So what is the formula? It is nothing but L di by dt plus 1 plus R I is equal to E. So we put the value. So what do I have? So di by dt is R upon L and E upon L. What is R upon L? So it is 25 upon 64. And what is this E upon L? So that is 500, so 50 upon 64. So this is nothing but 25 upon 32. Okay, and now when you try to solve this, again this is our first order linear differential equation. So when you try to solve this, what is the solution? Your I into integrating factor e raised to 25 by 64 t is equal to integration of the integrating factor 25 t by 64 into the right hand side, which is 25 by 32 dt plus c. Okay, so this is nothing but e raised to 25 t by 64 into 25 by 32 into 1 upon derivative of this 64 upon 25 plus c. So your I is, this gets cancelled, so 2 times I will have e raised to 5t by 64, that will go away because I have to multiply by minus of this, so it is nothing but only 2 plus c into e raised to minus 25t by 64. Okay, so I simply done the calculation. Even you can just pause the video and do it on your own. Okay, just cancel this out. Then I multiplied by e raised to minus 25 by 64 t. So this goes away and here with c I have minus. Now I of 0 is 0. So that means I of 0 is 0 means 0 is 2 plus c. So your c is minus 2. So if you put my c equal to minus 2, I have 1 minus this. Now as you can see, as t goes to infinity, this term will go to 0. So what is the maximum value? My maximum value of I is 2, 2 into 1 minus 0. So I have to find the time when this will reaches the 90% of the maximum value. So what is this? This is 0.9 into 2, which is 1.8. So I have to equate this equal to 1.8, if I am not wrong. Yes. So you divide by 2, you get 0.9. Take that, you get 1 minus 0.9 is 0.1. Take ln, so e will go away and you will get the value of time. So yeah, once you solve this, you get the value of t, and that's the time before it elapses 90% of the maximum value. So yeah, if I hope this is clear. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask me in the comment section. Let's go for the next problem. So we have to find the current in RC circuit. E is given, C is given. Now R is not constant, it is a function of t. So you have to be a little bit careful to solve this problem. I will give you the hint. RC circuit, so what is the differential equation? R dq by dt plus 1 by C q is equal to V or E, whatever notation you like. But what is dq by dt? It is nothing but our I. So what is your q? It is integration of I. Okay. Now you take derivative on both sides. So what do I get? When I take the derivative on both sides, I will get R into di by dt. People usually forget this step, R into R prime. They just write this as R di by dt. They don't write this. It's not their fault because usually we take R to be constant. But here R is a function of t. So when you differentiate, you need to take the product rule. Okay? And then plus 1 by c. What is derivative of integration? By fundamental theorem of calculus, it is I. Your E is constant, so I can directly write 0. If it is not constant, then I will write E dash. Okay? Now I think it's easy, right? You have R 200 minus T. So see, when your T is bigger than 200, my R is 0. So when R is 0, this is 0, this is 0. Your C will go there. Your I is also 0. So I'm only interested in this interval. Okay, so you take your R to be this. Your R prime will be minus 1. You put the value of C. You solve this. You get the answer. And yeah, use this initial condition. So in this problem, this is one thing you have to differentiate. While differentiating, you have to keep this point in mind. You have to apply the product rule. Okay, now let's go for two circuit problems. Now here you have two circuits. Okay, so when you had one circuit, you had one differential equation. Now you have two circuits, you will have two differential equation. And now that's where we come into the world of system of differential equations. So let's try to apply Kirchhoff's law to both the electric circuits. Let's go for the first one. What does the law say? Your voltage is equal to the sum of this remaining. Now from here the current is flowing. So L and I. So I have to use L di by dt, right? So here L1 into di1. So here I1 current is flowing and here I2 current is flowing. So here I1 current is flowing. So what is the equation? L1 di1 by dt plus, what is the next? R into I. So R1. But here I won't take only I1, because when I'm going from here through this R1, I1 is going like this and I2 is going like this. So I2 is in opposite direction. So it is R1 into, from this resistance, from this resistor, since I'm in this loop, it is I1 minus I2 is equal to 100. Now we put the value, 1000. So E is given to be 1000, so 1000 volt. L1 is 0.4, R1 is 0.5, and this is what you have. Okay, so when I do that, L1 is 0.4 and this is 0.5. So I have I1 prime, what is this, 5 by 4 into I1 minus I2 is equal to 1000 for this loop. For this loop, there is no external force. Here there is no external force. L2, what is L2? 0.5. L2 into di2 by dt. Plus, here again when I'm coming, so I'm going like this. So R1 into I2 minus I1, because I1 is opposite. Oh, here I forgot one more thing. So after coming, I have this also. So plus R2 I1 is equal to 1000, right? So here it will be, what is R2? R2 is 0.7. So 0.7 I1 equal to 1000. Here also L2 is 0.5, R1 is 0.5, I2 minus I1 equal to 0. So you have I1 prime, take everything on that side. You have I2 prime equal to, take this on that side. And you have I1 of 0 and I2 of 0. So you are having two first order linear differential equations in the unknowns I1 and I2. You write in them, it's a non-homogeneous because of this 1000. You write this in the matrix form, you find the eigenvalues. Since it is constant, you choose C1, C2 as your YP. You can go by any method, undetermined coefficients or variation of parameter, and then you can find I1 and I2. So whenever you have two circuits, you have to apply this law, Kirchhoff's law, and you have to write down the equations. Okay, so simply see, the only thing is, when you have the current flowing, you have to just take care. When I'm here, I will take I1 minus I2. And when I'm here, so I2 is going like this, but I1 is going like this. So this will be I2 minus I1. And then, yeah, here there is no external force equal to 0. Here I have power source, so this 1000. So if there are three circuits, you will have three differential equations. You have 1000 circuits in the line connected, you have 1000 differential equations. And that's why system of differential equations are very important to study. So I hope you have got the idea. And yeah, if there is any problem in which you have doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I will try to help that. And if everything is clear, then do support by liking and subscribing and sharing the video. Thank you.